Our next storyteller was a very last-minute addition to the show. He is one of the co-owners at Podcast Detroit. Please welcome Bob Waltenspiel.
So yeah, I just found out I was doing this about an hour ago. Literally, this is my first time ever doing anything like this with lights and all this stuff. I'm usually behind a microphone in a podcast studio. I've told this story once on a podcast and about maybe five times in public. I'm sorry, within a party. But here we go. So let's paint a picture, shall we? It's 1996, summertime, and my friend and I decide to venture out for the evening and have quarter draft night at the Hayloft Liquor Stand. And romantic, very beautiful setting, just where you want to be in the summer. And we're on the deck enjoying our quarter drafts, and this blonde walks by me, drop dead gorgeous, one of the prettiest women I've ever met in my life, or seen in my life at the time, and we end up striking up a conversation. And women like that usually don't talk to guys like me, right? I'm pretty much the same guy I was back then. Haven't changed a bit, except for got a little fatter, got a little grayer. We have tons in common. We're having a great conversation. We find out we have the same birthday. And it's like, you know, same music taste. The thing is, I'm like, oh my God, this girl actually might like me. So I ask for her number, right? Go figure. And she gives me a napkin, bar napkin. So I'm thinking, yeah, she wrote down a fake number. There's no way she likes me. She writes down her first name, her last name, her house number, and her beeper number. So I'm telling you, like, this girl actually likes me. So, you know, I wait, you know, because back then, the douchebag move was to wait 2 days and call, right? Not like now it's text me, go Netflix and chill. No, back then it was, let's wait 2 days. So I made it 2 days, and I call her. And I did another douchebag move, took her to dinner and a movie. And the whole time we ragged on people, and it was great. I'm like, well, we're both into ragging on people. It's amazing. And the same week, I said, I have the week off. She has the week off. We go to Cedar Point. I'm like, this doesn't happen. I'm like, third date. We're going to Cedar Point for the day. I could tell a whole other story on the Cedar Point story, but I'm just going to, for the sake of the harmonic. So about a month into this, we're inseparable. I'm talking three times a day, going out every day. You can't get us apart. And I work at Budweiser with him. I'm a sales guy. And I got 10th row center tickets at Pine Knob for her two out of her top five favorite bands, Def Leppard and Poison. So I'm like, I'm going to take this girl. I'm not taking clients. I don't want to lie to my boss. I'm going to take her out to two of her top five, 10th row center. I'm like a god. I'm 23. I can't afford those tickets. So I work at Budweiser, so what happens is I'm on the road all the time. I have to eat wherever I can get food. And so I'm late, and I need gas, and I'm hungry. So I know we're not going to eat at Pine Knob. What the hell do you eat there? So what do? I get gas, and I see the cooler at the gas station. And I go for it. The chicken salad sandwich and the salad.
No!
Right.
Whoa!
I'm Iron Gut, I eat White Castle, I'll be fine. So I go pick her up, and we get there, and I park, I got VIP parking. Seriously, I'm like, this is like, I'm pulling out all the stops. Right in her, well, let me rephrase. I drive in her two-day-old leased Ford Escort. Right, I'm driving, because I'm the guy, and I gotta, you know, I'm the guy. So, So we get through those concerts going on, and it's great. Def Leppard leads off, and life's going good, and they're getting towards the end of their set, and all of a sudden, I just hear the and it's my stomach, and I'm like, oh no, oh no. And have you ever seen Dumb and Dumber? It's like when Harry Met Sally, you know, and I'm like, I'm cheating! No, no, and it was like that, and I go, God bless it, I gotta poop at Pine Knob, this is gonna be hell. And then intermission comes up. And so help me God, I run down this, you know how Pine Knob is to the left and the right, right? And I'm on, I got VIP, like, passes to, like, the good bar, but I go to the right, and I go down the steps, and I'm kicking open stalls, and I'm kicking open stalls, and everyone just, like, a bomb went off, and overflowed, and pee everywhere, and I'm like, I don't know how you girls do it at public places. Like, I'm not a good nest builder. I don't know, like, how to, like, navigate this. And I'm like, I don't want to, like, search for, like, please, I got a TP in here. So I'm like, you know what? I got these VIP passes, and we can go to that nice bar, and I bet you there's clean bathrooms, because there's no animals that go in those, you know. So I wait to the end of the concert, so here comes Poison. And the whole Poison concert, I'm just like doing one of these. I'm just doing the little kid, the penguin walk, and I'm like, oh no. And it's just awful. So all of a sudden, Poison's done. And I know the encore's coming up. I'm like, I gotta go right now. Like, this is happening. So I grab her hand, she's like, the encore's still coming up. I'm like, listen, you've heard Every Rose Has Its Thorns already 100 times, so let's go. So I run down to the VIP bathroom, and it's like bliss, right? Freshly clean. It's like being in, like, you know, in grade school again, like the first one in school at 6:30 in the morning. The first one. Oh my gosh, thank God. And it's just a grenade goes off. And I'm like, all right, I'm feeling this weight off my shoulders. I feel so amazing. And this group of like 15 guys comes in, and every single one of them has to make a comment like, oh my God, it stinks like hell in here. Who did this? Me! And I'm supposed to, you know, that's the thing, like, with guys. Guys are like embarrassed, like I'm like, I'm giggling. Like, if you can make a man giggle in the bathroom, I totally won that day. So I'm like, I'm coming out of the bathroom, like giggling red face. It's like, are you okay? I'm like, yeah, I'm great, this is funny. So we grab beers and we're gonna go out afterwards. And then we finished our beers and we go to the car and I'm parked right in the front. If you've ever been to Pine Top, getting out of a concert is hell. It's literally hell. And I pull out. And we sit there for about 15, 20 minutes. We're not moving. And all of a sudden, here comes round two. The problem is this one's wet, I know. But, oh my God, no, please, no. And there's a car an inch in front of me, and there's a car an inch behind me. And I'm sitting there, and I'm just like, oh my God. And I'm trying to not let her see it. We've only been dating a month, mind you. I'm trying not to let her see that. I'm just like, and all of a sudden, I'm like, it's getting bad, like 10 minutes. And then, like, I'm getting these, like, contractions, like, at 9 minutes. And I'm punching the skin well. And I'm sweating from head to toe. And I'm just, you know, all of a sudden, it gets to 7 minutes, 6 minutes. She's like, oh my God, are you okay? Are you okay? I'm like, no, not okay. She goes, what's the matter? I got real bad again. She's like, just go. And I'm like, I'll be fine. Just go, I'll be fine. And I'm like, we're having this yelling argument over there. And all of a sudden she goes, you know, listen, the gates are so open, it's going to pan out, God damn it, just go, I'll scoot over your seat. And I'm, fine. So you all know, like, and now in my mind, I'm pooping, right? I'm going to get out of the car and I'm going to walk back into Pine Up. I thought I was going to hit like a McDonald's or something. No, I'm good. So I'm walking to the gates. And it's like the gates of Satan's hell shuts in my face. Like, I'm not pooping. So I told the guy, like, please let me in. You have no idea what I'm going through right now. I'm sweating. He's like, but I can't. It's like literally illegal. My boss will fire me. I can't. Oh no. So I get back in the car. She moves over and I sit down. Literally, I can't talk. And she's like, I wish I could have taken a picture, like the look on her face, like the look of death. Like, I'm never gonna speak to this woman again. I just screwed everything up, right? Like, I thought we were gonna, like, spend the rest of our lives together. Babies, and I'm like, God, I love her. And I'm like, I just want to feel better. I just want to feel better. And like 3 minutes is getting out of 2 minutes, and all these contractions. And I go, you know what? I got a great idea. Maybe if I just fart a little bit, I'll feel better. No, it didn't happen. So I'm screaming, crying. Help! No! I'm like, no, I didn't just shit my pants. My girlfriend's car. And then, like, literally 10 seconds later, the car in front of me pulls up. So what do? I make a right, and I go on the grass, and I go 50 miles an hour to the trees, cut it like Dukes of Hazzard. I strip butt naked, running through the forest like Sasquatch in the woods, and I'm sure they took pictures of me. And I completely make myself feel better. I destroy one of the trees. Thank God I wore one of those t-shirt wife beaters under my shirt. So I did a little spritz, you know, I'm okay. So now the walk of shame, right? I'm going back to her car. And I was like, complete unspoken word. To this day, I have no idea what I said to her, if I called her the next day, or how I got home that night. But all I know is tonight I'm gonna go home and see her at home with my three beautiful daughters.